And welcome back, folks. Welcome back to a new Let's Play. Today we're going to play a very special game. Of course, I always say that, but it is especially true this time. But why is this game special, you may ask? Well, first of all, it is special because I do connect some childhood memories with it. I didn't play a lot of games as a child, and I didn't play this game either. Yeah, I never played this game, in fact. So I'm very excited to finally play it today. But I do remember this game. I mean, I remember this game coming out back in 1995. In fact, that was the very first trip abroad that I did. And yeah, these beautiful green boxes that this game was packaged. I didn't ask my parents to buy this game. In any case, I also saw some advertisements for this game in a German. In fact, I still own that very issue that contained a review of that game, which was quite favorable, in fact. It is also a special game on its own merit. In fact, it is a very unique game. It's a one of its kind game, basically. And it's also remarkable because for its time, this game was quite advanced. First of all, it was one of the very first 3D games. Well, proper 3D games. It wasn't game is the characters. They are textured 3D models, but all the backgrounds, they're just pre-rendered. So yeah, static image attached to it. So of course, all the camera angles, they are static too. But for its time, it was, yeah, it had some, I mean, I remember this review I talked about in this PC Joker magazine, highly praising the beautiful look of this game and the advanced graphics, which might be a bit of an absurd statement if you compare it to modern graphics. But of course, I mean, this was 1995, so this was 1 year before Quake came out, which completely revolutionized, I mean, redefined the standards for 3D games. It was not just remarkable. It was not just technologically remarkable for its graphics, but also for the animations. And in fact, all the animations that your character performs, which is, as I already said, an actual 3D model, all of these animations, they were captured using motion capture, which was very novel for the time. And in fact, the company that developed this game, which by the way is Origin Systems, the same company which made the beloved Ultima and the Wing Commander series, motion capture technology for this game. So it was completely, in 1997, that even in the year 1997, that was also, it is, I mean, nowadays we take all these things for granted. However, there's something that even modern games can learn from this one. You control your character using the numpad, well, at least scheme. First of all, it works really well in very fine control over your character. In combat, there isn't just an attack button like in modern fighting games. I mean, there are, well, 10 of these, basically, and you can make a low kick with the left leg, a low kick with the right kick, you can punch. So there are a lot of combat moves that you can pull off individually. And the only game I can actually think of that had the same agency over your own character was Die by the Sword, which had a different control scheme, but allowed you also very fine-grained control over your character. So for all of the mentioned reasons, this is a very special game. Unfortunately, it didn't do very well commercially, and so somehow this game got lost in time and nobody seems to remember it. But we are going to change that, because we are going to play this game today. And this game, of course, is Bioforge. As I already said, released in 1995 and developed by... And when we are going to play this game, you might actually... When this game was released, it was marketed as an interactive movie. When you hear the term interactive movie, you of course think of FMVs that basically incited Richard Garriott and his team. All of these games are Dragon Slayer. You have some pre-recorded. But Richard Garriott was not satisfied with this state of this genre, and so he wanted to revolution. I mean, he wanted to make a change. And I will quote his statement on interactive movies. Interactive movies have become a buzzword, so it's being applied to games which really aren't. Just because a game has FMV doesn't automatically make it an interactive movie, because you have very little control over the actor. Neither is a game in which you click on an icon, then sit back and watch a scene take place. Yeah. So it will be interesting, I think, to see how this game actually is an interactive movie. I mean, it's certainly interactive, but it may not be so obvious how it's a movie. So I'm very excited to play it. And so, without any further ado, let's start.
This is Marine Dropship Ronick to control, making final approach for delivery of supply requisition B9-3Q and prisoner AP-127.
This is control to Marine Dropship Ronick. Landing platform is in position. You are cleared to land, Ronick.
Tower to control room, the main gun is offline. Da-dum! What a cool intro. At least I think it's pretty cool. Okay. Some context in the introductory cutscene. The man that you saw being operated upon, I mean, technically didn't see him. Well, technically you did if you did pay very close attention, because you could see a reflection in the mask that the operator was, I mean the surgeon was wearing. So you could say our protagonist in the reflection, actually. So the guy that was being operated upon in the introductory cutscene that we just saw is our protagonist, which is called Lex. And we don't know why we are being operated upon. And in fact, we probably don't even know that we are called Lex, because our character suffers from amnesia. And yeah, so our goal is in this game to figure out why these things that have been done to us have been done to us. Yeah, and we have to figure out also who we are. So let us actually, without any further ado, start the game. There are three difficulty set levels. Easy combat, medium combat, and hard combat. And the difference between easy and medium and easy and hard is when you're performing two combat movements in a row, there is a penalty in medium and hard difficulty. Namely, the second time you perform the same move in a row, it is less effective. So, in other words, you can't just keep spamming the same combat movement over and over again. You have to be a little bit more creative. That's the main difference between easy and the other difficulties. Otherwise, I think also the enemies have slightly higher HP. We are going to play on medium, actually. This might sound a bit adventurous, but I think I can handle this, actually. So let us start. Okay, and right from the very beginning, the game is not fucking around, because this nurse bot, it would have attacked us, and it would have eventually also killed us. That is the reason why I attacked the nurse bot first. So we've disabled the nurse bot. Now we need to actually destroy it. And the way we do this, we actually push him into the force field. Like this. Okay, I failed to push the bot into the force field, but maybe. Okay. Aha! Kaboom! And if you listen closely, you heard a scream there. This scream was actually not the scream of our protagonist, but of someone else. And we are going to find out who that was in a moment. I want to make some comments. As you just saw there, when I at first failed to push the Norsebot into the force field, this shows how this game really is interactive. I mean,
I mean, obviously all games are interactive in one way or the other, but many games, they are sort of split, really split in half. They're the gameplay parts, and then they're the cutscene parts, or the parts where things are scripted. And even in many modern games, maybe in like Half-Life, many sequences are completely scripted. And if this was a modern game, then probably when I would have hit the nurse bot, no matter how, where I was standing, it would have always played the same scripted sequence where the bot would be flying into the force field. However, in this game, this is not the case. You really have to perform your moves in such a way that the trajectory that is being imposed upon by the game's physics actually go through the force field. So this is I think something cool about this game.
A hunk of meat.
That hunk of meat has actually serves a purpose. You can eat it, actually, but I wouldn't advise it because somehow the description here is a bit glitched out. Okay, now it's has unglitched. Okay, yeah, it's dried meat, but it exhibits severe spoilage, so you shouldn't really eat it. And there's a better way, in fact, to regain HP, namely, if you go into the snazzy diagnostic screen, you have a health bar and an energy bar, and if you are injured in combat, you can actually repair yourself with the biological repair unit that is sort of built into yourself, and trade basically health and energy for health. Okay, but we wouldn't know that because we actually don't know anything except that a logbook, a dining room, except that, well, we have amnesia and someone had operated upon us. Let us read this logbook. I know what they will do to me. They will mutilate my flesh and make it into something inhuman. They can completely alter the state of my mind. But they shall not break my spirit. I am determined. I swear with every ounce of my will that who I am, my internal nature, cannot be twisted or cut out of me. No matter what occurs, I will remain unchanged. Well, at least physically, we are probably very much changed from what we were before. And now we want to check out, where that scream was coming from. Because this scream was coming, in fact, from this cell.
If you come from the Borg, you'll be sorely disappointed.
Okay, it might be seem a bit strange that he would talk about a fork. And even stranger is the fact that this very fork is, in fact, the very thing that we need from him. As you see here, he lost one of his arms. This is actually an important fact which you can exploit in order to more easily defeat him. Yeah, I'm already spoiling a little bit, and I'm going to save here because, last time I tried this, he really beat my ass, and I don't want to have to restart the game. Okay. This guy will attack you as soon as you enter his prison. As you saw, he was already trying to punch us. But you can use the meat to your advantage. Namely, this will provide a little distraction maneuver. Must be careful not to step into the force field. Okay. He will grab this chunk of meat, and this will allow us, and while he's doing that, he will actually not attack us. And this allows us to actually go into combat mode and position ourselves
not be enemies. We should work together.
Position ourselves in such a way that we are in a good fighting position. Yeah.
You stand upon
shit.
Holy
okay.
ground.
And already this fight is not going as it should. And as you, if you've listened there a bit closely, this high-pitched scream, this will always occur when you hit him in his, in the left, in his left arm. I mean, the remainders of his left arm, and then we are dead. Okay.
After the random looping of your entrails.
Okay, this fight didn't go very well. Yes. So actually, combat in this game, well, at least the first combat, it is actually not that hard. Meaning that it is perfectly possible to defeat him, having, well, no problems at all and taking no damage. But sometimes you just, yeah, if you are unlucky and you have a bad positioning, he will just beat your ass. So, okay, let us try this again. And as you saw there, the second time I tried this shit. Something isn't working. Okay. Yeah, as you saw there, when I performed the same combat move the second time, it was actually slower and less effective. Shit. And shit.
We should not be enemies. We should work together. I have no wish to harm you.
Another interesting thing, or a useful thing to observe, is that shit. That different combat moves have different ranges of attack. Like these two different low kicks, the left low kick and right kick. They have different, ranges. The left kick has a slightly slightly
upon holy ground.
Slightly lower range. Okay. And now I can't see anything. Shit. Yeah, the camera isn't really brilliant. Shit, fuck, and we're dead.
After the random looping of your entrails.
Okay. When I tried this fight previously, it was actually a lot easier. So trust me on this one, I am actually capable of defeating him. I mean, I have defeated him several times. I have defeated him several times already. As I had to, basically try recording this game several times now. Recording this game is actually quite difficult. Well, I mean, recording it in a good quality, that is. I don't want to go really into all the details here, but let us just say that
we should not be enemies. We should work together. You stand upon
recording this game is
ground.
Difficult.
It's fitting you should kneel.
Yeah, there's also a backflip that you can perform. And as I mentioned in the introduction, all these animations here, they were captured from an actual actor using motion capture. So, yeah, I think that's also
It's also visible because these animations, they're actually looking quite good. Okay, we should always try to hit his injury, because this way you can defeat him much faster.
One must be removed.
Okay. Shit. 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 Fuck. Shit. Shit. Fuck. Shit. And we're dead again. Oh my god. Fuck you, Kanan. Fuck you. Okay, now I'm really angry, but we will defeat him. We will defeat this motherfucker. Okay. Okay, wait until the... Yeah, we can step into this, into his room. Now, let us try this again.
We should not be enemies. We should work together. I have no wish to harm you.
Aha! Take this. You're dead! Yes!
I'm sorry, my friend. We are both victims, you and I.
Well, actually, he is not our friend. He is just a stranger. And when we'll come back, folks, we are going to take his fork. Haha. Until next time, folks. Until then.